welcome back all my seniors with Oklahoma County TRIAD. We have a network of seniors and some who may not be in the network that are watching today. We want to thank you for tuning in. We've done a great many public service announcements, and this one should be of really good interest to you. So we understand there's a lot of seniors who have rental property that some tenants have lost their jobs because of the COVID pandemic. And so we thought it would be very, very helpful to get you educated on what legal aid is. So I want you to say hello to my good friend. This is Rick Wallowitz. We've worked together 6 years, and he is the senior law project attorney with Legal Aid Services of Oklahoma. Say hello to my friends.
Well, hello, everybody. Thank you for having me out here, Kim.
Absolutely. So let's start with, for those seniors out there that don't really know, what is legal aid?
Okay, legal aid is a law firm that's established by the federal government through the Legal Services Act of 1974. That was actually the very last thing that Richard Nixon signed before he got on the helicopter after he resigned. But we help people with civil legal problems. And in general, civil legal problems are anything but criminal cases. So that would include a wide variety of things, from bankruptcy to housing cases to consumer cases to domestic violence, all down the line. My particular part of legal aid is the Senior Law Project, and it comes in two flavors. We have a generalist, me, who can help people with general issues, and then we have an attorney embedded with Sunbeam who helps people, seniors, with domestic violence types of issues as well.
Great. So I want to just open this up to how seniors who are watching today might connect with legal aid.
Okay. Well, our offices are at 2901 North Classen.
Okay.
Suite 112, right on the first floor. Of course, our offices are closed right now because of the lockdown. However, our general number is 521-1302.
Okay.
And if you call that number, you'll probably connect it to our splash line. Splash line is 60 plus legal aid services helpline. And that's a line dedicated to seniors and senior issues. Hopefully that will help you get help more quickly. And if it's just a question that you have or need a little bit of advice, then there may be someone manning the helpline that could actually answer your questions on the site. If it's not something that can be handled over the phone, then the helpline will refer the client to their local legal aid office. And legal aid covers all 77 counties in Oklahoma.
I didn't realize that. So what is the biggest segment of the calls that you're getting? What are people needing help with right now that you could enlighten our listening audience to?
Right now, one of the big issues is unemployment. There are a lot of seniors who are out there still working, of course, and unemployment is a big problem. And kind of tied to that, people are losing their income or having their income reduced, and they've been living from check to check anyway, and now they're in especially hard straits because of foreclosures, evictions, and so on.
What else would you like to talk about in order to enlighten our seniors?
Well, you know, something that I talk about quite often is scams that are targeting seniors.
Right.
And that relates to basically all scams are targeting seniors. They're the hottest scam demographic group.
Right.
In America. And thing is, while we're seeing an increase in that, we're also seeing probably about one out of every 23 cases being reported, so it's vastly underreported,
right,
as well. Sometimes this scammer can be one of the victim's own family or someone that they depend on for care.
Yes.
So I'd like to talk about those issues as well.
Absolutely. I've had a couple of seniors call and say they've received some kind of word, whether it be phone call, email, or something through the mail that says, you know, they, because the Social Security office is shut down, they're going to discontinue their Social Security, or if they don't pass a COVID test and prove that they don't have it, then, you know, they're going to not get their Social Security. So what are some of the scams that you're seeing?
Well, there are a lot of scams involving applying for public benefits or the stimulus benefits and so on. Give us your number so we can verify it when you call, or give us your bank account number so we're sure where to send the money to, etc. And right. Those are basically just identity theft scams.
Right.
We have a lot of phony charities cropping up.
Yes.
And want people to deliver. Now, you know, Oklahoma is kind of unique because for the last several years, it's always been in the top four or five charitable givers slash volunteering to help someone or somebody else. We're very giving people in Oklahoma.
We're in the heartland, yeah.
And so, you know, they're using that type of thing against us. Mm-hmm. Kind of, that's the thing about scammers is they can turn anything worthwhile into
right.
something to profit from them.
Right.
We also see a lot of increases in phony medical problems.
Yes.
For example, we've got this medication now, and this is the one that the doctors in the pharmacy doesn't want you to know about. But we'll make it available for you for $29.99. It'll cure COVID, acne, whatever. And a lot of people in desperate straits will cling to that. We'll fall for those. And so that's something else that we have that we're watching for our seniors.
You know, it just made sense to me to have you on to talk about this because, and I go back to Charles Fuselier, who was the founding father of TRIAD in St. Martinsville Parish, Louisiana. And, you know, his dad was a sheriff. His dad died, and he wanted to follow in his father's footsteps. He didn't really need the job. He's independently wealthy, but he went to, you know, law enforcement academy, and they elected him sheriff. And the first thing that he really saw was when he wanted to know what was going on in a certain area of his community, he would go to church and ask the little ladies in the Sunday school class, and they would go, oh, yeah, green truck, it was by here yesterday at 2:00. Do you want the tag number? Because they were the little Miss Kravitz looking out the window, and they would report everything when someone else was the victim. The reason he fathered TRIAD was because these same seniors who feel that very deep-seated sense of community and would report everything when someone else was the victim was because they wouldn't report it when they were the victim. So that high respect and regard that they have for law enforcement hindered them. Their thinking was they don't want to take a gun off the street who's chasing a rapist to you know, file a report because someone stole their television set that they didn't bother writing a serial number down. They felt like it was hopeless. So I think that sometimes seniors, and I continually have to convince them, it's okay to call 911. Even if you think something is going on. So fresh on their lips is suspicious person, suspicious vehicle, suspicious activity. You must always remember that, you know, when you get something in the mail or you have questions, you can call my office, you can absolutely call 911, but the legal aid law firm stands ready to help you with these questions. So calling this number will put them through to a senior helpline.
Yes.
All right. Is there anything that you want to add?
Well, just what you brought up kind of leads me to maybe three or four sub-points.
Okay, come on.
All right. And so the one thing is that one of the scammer's best friends is loneliness.
Yes.
Loneliness and isolation. Seniors are now locked down.
They're, more than ever.
They're at home.
Yeah.
They have their usual support system is kind of interrupted. You know, one of the best things that have occurred for seniors, I think, is the mobile meals program
right.
and churches with senior ministries that that kind of keep watching. You know, they know who's coming up, who stopped showing up, who's coming with bruises, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And that's taken away now.
The senior centers, yeah.
Right.
I mean, I go in there, they're not, you know, that was, that money was put there not just to feed them for nutrition, or for socialization, and now they don't have the socialization to go in and be able to put a puzzle together with a buddy or play cards or dominoes or canasta or what have you. It's so sad. So the seniors that we stepped in to serve, who were isolated before this whole COVID thing, are now even more so isolated. So loneliness, that's number one. Give me another one.
Number two is, you spoke about, you know, assigning a police officer to a raping is more important than a consumer call or that sort of thing. Now, think of it is that a lot of these are scams, okay? And they are also, at the same time, crimes. They could be embezzlement, they could be burglary, they could be fraud, any number of things that are hardcore crimes. And in addition to that, there is pretty solid body of expertise out there that say that if a person is consistently abused, especially senior, they're more prone to depression, their life, you know, their life expectancy is shorter. And so it's a big mistake to think about it as like, well, it's just money. It's not.
But I can see where it kind of has that snowball effect.
Yeah.
Because, you know, first they're lonely to begin with, which depression kind of is the first cousin to loneliness. And, you know, then that abuse comes in, whether it be financial, and then they get depressed. Mm-hmm. They get their days and nights mixed up, and that kind of plays into not taking their medications right, which leads to even more depression. And, you know, now they've proven that Alzheimer's is directly associated with depression. So, yeah, even when we, you know, feel like going to bed and covering up our head and just thinking about all the bad things that we're going through, we've got to get up and move.
Yeah, it requires action. Mm-hmm. And one of the things to remember is that scamming is
a
domestic violence issue.
Yes.
And then B, you know, we get the old, well, why doesn't he just leave, or why doesn't she just leave? It takes time, especially if you're talking with a person who's dependent or a long-term relationship. Usually they make several unsuccessful efforts to get out.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same thing in these situations.
Yes, it is. So I find with most all financial scams, there is this underlying common denominator of that vicious sense of emergency. You must make the decision right now. Would you agree that is one of the biggest red flags?
Right, and you see that a lot with home improvement scams or home repair scams, where somebody just shows up and says, hey, you know, I've got this extra set of shingles from a drive down the block, and, you know, I'll give it to you as a discount, but you're going to have to pay $500 cash by 4 o'clock, or else we can't do that.
Right.
That's always should be a red flag. But again, going back to the isolation issue, I've had people, mostly they're older women, who have said, well, they didn't have the cash at home, and so they let the bad guy scammer drive them to their bank. They withdraw the money, and then they let the scammer drive them back. Now, you don't have to use a whole lot of imagination to see what all else they're putting at risk rather than just their money.
Right.
But that is a very, very common scam. And if somebody is trying to offer you a contract and it sounds a little too good to be true,
probably,
and you want to get a second pair of eyes, whether it's an attorney or a trusted friend or whatever, on the document, they seem reluctant, that should be a deal that you should run rather than walk away from.
So for my tech-savvy seniors, how would one get a hold of legal aid online?
They could contact OK Law.
OK Law.
Yeah, and that'll be Legal Aid's, that's Legal Aid's website. And what they'll find online applications.
Okay.
And they'll also find online information. And I think one of the better part of our information for seniors, and not just because I helped write it, but is our little black book of scams.
Yes.
And that'll be available there too. And it'll go through.
So you can just download it and print it?
Sure.
Or download and read it? Okay.
And, you know, that, we keep that updated, you know, if a new scam comes
right.
in, we put it in the book. So that should keep you up to date on what the scam is, how to avoid it, and who to call.
Very good. Very good. Anything else you'd like to add before we say goodbye to our friends?
Just be careful. Legal aid takes elder abuse very seriously. And we also know that this is a time that's kind of unprecedented.
It is.
And so a lot of the book is still being written as we go along. But the Legal Services Corporation, which is our parent organization, has released additional funding. We'll be opening up new programs to deal with COVID. We'll be hiring new lawyers to deal with it as well.
Okay.
We're looking at this in terms of a natural disaster, as we would in a ice storm or a tornado or something along those lines, that we'll be setting up a lot of special programs for elders in the near future.
Yeah.
And not just elders, but anyone suffering from the economic impact of COVID.
So we're hearing a lot from seniors with questions about wills and estates and probate issues. Can you enlighten my listeners on where to go, what to do, and what you have for them considering these three issues?
Sure. Now, in the wake of the COVID virus, experts in estate planning are looking at probably what they predict to be the largest transfer of wealth in American history.
Wow.
Maybe up to about $45 trillion in property and things passing hand. And I recommend that everybody have at least four documents: a trust, a will, a durable power of attorney, and a healthcare power of attorney. Sometimes in Oklahoma that last word is called an advance directive.
Right.
But these are the documents I think you need to say, I'm prepared now.
Okay.
Because you have someone who's willing to talk for you or to take care of business for you when you can't do it for yourself.
What if you can't afford to have all these drawn up?
Well, legal aid does it for free.
That's the key that I wanted to get to. Okay.
And then there are a lot of people in that donor hole kind of who have too much money to qualify for legal aid, but yet not enough to handle their attorney's fees for estate planning. And for those people, we partner with churches, charities, other civic groups in doing will clinics. And in the course of the will clinics, we use volunteer attorneys as well as legal aid attorneys, and they can help us out with those people in that donor hole, so that we're trying to reach as many as we can.
Right.
But another thing you have to watch out for is that there are a lot of scam will and estate packets out there. There are things that are not appropriate to the law in Oklahoma. They might be appropriate to wherever they were drawn up, but not here.
Right.
There are some things that are identity scams.
Right.
In order to apply for our services and get our online will director for you, give us your social security number, give us a bank reference credit card number, something along those lines. And there are also a couple of scams that every once in a while, it's an old scam, but it gets dusted off once in a while. And they're usually called Freedom Trusts or Liberty Trusts or something patriotic, Super Trusts sometimes. And what they are is just basically a pyramid scheme. And you pay money, you never see the product, and you never see a place that has a brick and mortar address. And so you pay that money, and then they say, what you really need is one of our superpowered probate trusts. So, that'll be another $500.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times all they get is a fancy fake leather binder.
Yeah.
And 33 pages, which maybe four or five of them are useful.
Right.
So they look real nice, but it's kind of an illusion.
Right.
And if you are qualified for legal aid, if you are a senior, that's 60 or above, and you live in our service area.
60 years of age and above, okay.
You live in our service area, and you're a U.S. citizen, we will do it for free, and we know that it's going to be legally proper in Oklahoma, and you can't beat that price in any internet thing.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Sounds good. Thank you so much for being here. I am so thankful that we got, because there's going to be some changes with respect to wills, estates, and probate. In other words, people that have been putting it off are now forced to do something.
Right.
they're looking at this very seriously. So thank you so much for being here. I so very much appreciate your time.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Ah, this is so good. SPLASH is the acronym for the 60 plus legal aid service hotline, SPLASH. So get a pen and write this down. Any kind of wills, trusts, probate, living wills, that any questions you have, if you are 60 plus US citizen, you can call the toll-free helpline. So it's 1-855-488-6814. Legal Aid Services of Oklahoma, making equal justice for all a reality. So even when you can't afford an attorney, Oklahoma steps in to help.